must also remind you that masks must be worn at all times. Now, sit back, relax, and let us take you to musical comedy heaven.
Thank you. Kirk and Miss Bryce.
Thank you, John.
Mr. Arnstein back yet?
Not yet.
But it's tonight.
Tonight's the night.
I'll keep an eye out for him.
What time's his train? Telegram didn't say. You might go straight to the house. He'll want to see the baby.
Should I phone?
Mama's there. If he shows, she'll call him.
You want to start dressing?
If I knew what I wanted, I swear I'm driving myself crazy.
How about a little courage?
That ain't gonna do it. Look at this new wardrobe. How about a little courage?
Such as that. Is a nose with deviation such a crime against dragons. Mwah!
Don't you worry, Mrs. Strakosh. One day, the whole world will look at me and be... stunned.
Go! Toy, 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 break a leg!
From the top!
Gonna hear a voice, a silver flute.
Now she in reach, don't come back. That kid is to whack when I expose it. Now can't you see, don't look at me, that I'm a
so.
Have you guessed yet? Who's the best cat?
gentlemen, it is with great pride that Mr. Thomas Keeney presents a Keeney Theater discovery, making her Keeney Theater stage debut. Please welcome, in a Keeney Theater exclusive engagement, the one and only irrepressible, uniquely individual stylist of the song and story,
Miss Fanny Bryce! Hit it, Professor!
I beg your pardon?
absolutely the most gorgeous thing I've ever seen in my life. What's it, silk?
It's French handkerchief linen. Goat's very limp, though.
Like something out of a magazine.
Most of the tailcoats I seen rented, you know, got stiff shirts.
Well, they should have. This is just a conversation piece.
Sure, I get it. Sorry, I don't get it. I never got past third grade.
It just means something for people to talk about, and I'm sure you learned everything you needed by the third grade.
So, you're someone I should know?
Well, if you're asking if I'm an expert on theater, the answer is no. But they say I have an eye for what's unique, and you, Miss Bryce, are that. I predict that one day you are going to be a very big star.
You're the first person to say that. It wasn't a relative.
Well, I won't be the last.
Well, look who's slumped.
I believe this is yours.
Those were some sweet odds.
Well, that was an unfortunate rainstorm.
For you?
My horse is just no good on a sloppy track.
You didn't have to come all the way down here. Your credit's good.
Well, this is how it got good.
Hey, Mr. Keeney, you get around to thinking about me yet?
$40 a week. Take it or leave it.
Leave it. I'm offering her 65.
Since when you in the biz?
I was authorized by one of your competitors. Keep my eyes open, should I see something special?
I'm something special?
$65 a week, Miss Bryce, plus dinner.
Plus dinner?
What do you say?
75.
85.
90.
100.
110.
Oh. Sorry. I wasn't authorized to go above 100. She's all yours for $110 a week.
Plus dinner.
Plus dinner. Congratulations.
Thanks. Jesus, Mary,
Jordan. $110? I'm practically a millionaire! So, who's the competitor? Zipa, right? No, I'm only kidding. Who?
No one.
No one? You mean you were bluffing? Like in a card game? And what if Keeney had stopped first?
You would have lost the job.
I would have.
I was willing to take that chance.
You were willing? Ain't you something? Wow. Those yours?
I'm minding them. For Fred.
I could look like that. In another lifetime.
You're perfect just as you are.
Boy, have you got good manners. Well, I better let you go. They look hungry.
If there's ever anything I can do for you, let me give you my card. I know a lot of people.
Nick Arnstein. Arnstein? What do you know? Nick Arnstein, Hotel Astor. Nicky Arnstein, Nicky Arnstein, what a beautiful, beautiful name.
Good night, Miss Bryce, and good luck.
Nicky Arnstein, Nicky Arnstein, what a beautiful, beautiful bubble. And tell whoever washes your shirt a little starch in the last rinse and it won't go so limp.
Don't forget.
Wearing a full dress form, but we're not even going to a wedding. What?
You've never heard of Nick Arnstein?
Of course I have, just now.
The guy's a legend.
A high roller.
He's got his hands in everything. Boxing, racing, chorus girls.
Oh, then he knows who Ziegfeld. He could even know Mr. Wrigley from Spearmint.
He's dated a girl from every show on Broadway.
towels?
One day, Annie, when I have nothing else to do, I'll explain to you all about girls.
This is humiliating. You do know that I'm Fanny's boss.
Turn now, boss later.
So what do you think, Eddie? Is it a job or an audition?
It's gotta be a job.
But why wouldn't it say so?
She's right. All the telegram says is, "Dear Miss Price, stop. I'd like to see you at the New Amsterdam Theater this Thursday at 4 o'clock. Stop. Sign Florence Ziegfeld." Ha-ha! Look at that by heart. Like the Pledge of Allegiance.
So now, recite later.
I wonder how a mama came to name a boy Florence.
It's Florence.
Oh, and that's better?
Pen's done.
Wait, gotta put on the fur!
You know what I think? Someone talked to him about me. There was this guy backstage one time, Nick Arnstein, just the kind of guy who would know Ziegfeld.
That was a year ago.
So I could have slipped his mind.
The paper's been printing stuff about you for months, but a telegram arrived and suddenly it's all on account of that schmo.
Yeah, I bet it was him.
This fur has been on God knows how many coats and God knows what else.
My stomach aches.
Because you're making yourself crazy. Why'd you have to have a new dress now?
So I wouldn't be nervous. Mama. Mama, feel my head. Have I got a fever? I think I'm dying.
You're not dying. You're built like a horse.
It's all coming too easy. That's what got me scared. Where's the suffering an artist is supposed to go through before cooking, Mrs. Mika? Where's the setbacks, the hard knocks to learn from? Where's the torture?
Here's the torture. You take it off. You put that on. Who says you're gonna get the job, huh? And even if you do, who says you won't get fired in a week? Cheer up, Fanny. Fanny's always waiting right around the corner.
Greetings and salutations.
You can't say hello like a normal human being?
I brought grapes!
Well, then all
as I was saying, I never taxi on my way home from my married daughter Sadie's when I pass by Keeney's Theater. And outside, I see a picture of the girl who was opening in the new show. Guess who the girl isn't?
I'll give it a shot. The girl isn't my unmarried daughter, Fanny.
So how come?
Because she ain't in a show.
Uh-huh.
Oh, Sarah Straycott, when I am worried about my daughter's career, I will send to you a telegram, like someone sent one to her. My dear Fanny, stop. Please do me a big personal favor and come to the New Amsterdam Theater this Thursday at 4 o'clock in regards to your starring in the new Ziegfeld Folly. Stop! Love and kisses, signed Florence Ziegfeld!
The Ziegfeld Follies? In person? In my dreams, I could have never dreamt. Oh, Fanny, darling, now you belong to the ages.
Mrs. Ziegfeld, Mimsy's headdress is too high for the set.
Change the set!
Wouldn't it be easier to change the headdress?
Easier, not better.
Is that Mr. Ziegfeld? Where is he?
Up above, like God.
Mr. Ziegfeld! Mr. Ziegfeld!
Yes, Miss Price.
If it's all the same to you, I'm gonna skip the finale.
What was that, Miss Price?
Mrs. Ziegfeld, I can't sing. I am the beautiful reflection of my love's affection. They'll laugh at me.
You're a comic. They're supposed to laugh at you.
With me, not at me. How about I just do cornet man and we call it a night?
May I remind you that you are in my theater?
And no one argues with the landlord.
That is exactly what I mean. If I take you out of the banana, I'll also take you out of the follies. I do the orders.
Okay, fine, of course. But when you see me prancing around in a fancy dress, telling the audience how beautiful I am, you'll be sorry.
That's your opinion.
Whose opinion should I have, Henry Houdini's?
That's Harry Houdini.
That's your opinion.
exactly as written.
Does it gotta be in English?
Miss Price!
Yes, Mrs. Ziegfeld. You're the boss, Mrs. Ziegfeld. Whatever you say, Mrs. Ziegfeld, go ahead.
Present, with justifiable pride, Florence Ziegfeld glorifying the American bride. You are the beautiful reflection of his love's affection, a walking illustration of his adoration. His love makes you beautiful, so beautiful.
from?
And wasn't my fanny wonderful? Hello, Mr. Ziegfeld. Fanny's mama.
And this is a friend of hers, Eddie Ryan. Eddie!
This is Lawrence Ziegfeld. Eddie is a very talented dance director, Mr. Ziegfeld.
Congratulations, Mr. Ziegfeld.
A pleasure.
Don't look now, Eddie, but you're shaking hands with the genius. Who but the great Ziegfeld would think of putting a beautiful bridal gown on a girl in the family way? Who? You tell me, who?
Only one person I know.
Hi, Mr. Ziegfeld. So we went good, huh?
There are a few things we need to discuss.
Oh! All right, Rosie, we should go. Mrs. Price is throwing a party for Fanny at her saloon. She's expecting half the neighborhood.
Half? All, Mr. Ziegfeld, come. It's just friends, and believe me, in Brooklyn, you won't be the great Ziegfeld. You'll just be Florence. Flo?
No,
not Flo, Mr. Ziegfeld. You'll be Mr. Ziegfeld. 24 Henry Street. You'll come?
That Eddie, by the way, is some hoofer. You ought to consider him
pretty mad, huh?
Miss Price, I think you owe me an apology.
You didn't like it?
As a matter of fact, I did like it.
I'll apologize if you will. I'll even go first. I apologize. Go ahead!
Miss Price, if you ever flout my authority again, I will ring the curtain down on you. Have I made myself clear?
Crystal clear.
In that case, Miss Price, I apologize too, and I thought you were wonderful.
So maybe I could have another number?
What?
And here's the thing, and I feel really definite about this. I choose my own material.
What?
Songs, you know, la la la.
Good evening, and congratulations, both of you.
It's you.
You remember me.
You were my first ruffled shirt. Any more competitors? I can always use a raise.
Ziegfeld has no competitors.
Good to see you, Nick. How are the ponies running?
Well, not as good as you and this little girl.
I had a hunch the two of you belong together.
I have the same hunch, and it's aging me fast.
I knew it. I was sure it was you told him about me.
I wish I had, but I'm afraid not.
I don't believe you.
Well, I can call him back. You can ask yourself.
Oh, you probably fixed it up that way between you.
Well, there comes a moment where honesty is useless, so have it your way. But as your benefactor, very proud of you.
I did good, huh?
Ah, it didn't surprise me. After all, I had written a card with your flowers before the curtain even went up. I hope you like my roses.
Dear Star, I told you so.
If you were a horse, I would have bet on you.
Do your horses always win?
No, but they're always the best on the track. You are very funny. The old-timey accent, looking at you, you remind me of my grandma.
Stop, another compliment like that, I won't be able to get my hat on.
And what I mean is, you and the audience, they trust you like old friends.
Hamish.
Hamish.
You sure your name is Arnstein? Hamish, familiar, comfortable.
That's what it means.
Boy, did we grow up on different sides of the track.
Yet we find ourselves together. So what do we do about it?
We gotta do something!
Well, what's the point of succeeding if you're not gonna brag? You've gotta make the rounds, hit all the hot spots, make grand entrances, and have people stare and whisper and say, there's Ziegfeld's new star. Who's that lucky guy with him? I want to see me sing with you on my arm, to where you your glitter decorating my arm. Thou naturally such proximity gives room to rise. Well, let them analyze what our amalgamation implies. Oh, yes, the gossips will press, so willing to stress. The seamy side, no what, so what. Let's get give this town a light and hit it like a meteorite. Tonight I wanna be seen with you.
My mother's got the whole neighborhood waiting on me. I gotta go. You wanna come?
I'd love to.
You don't mean it.
Of course I do. It's not every day that a bonafide, glorified, zinc-filled girl invites me to Brooklyn.
I wouldn't want you to waste your evening.
How could I? I'd be with you. Just gotta charming, and you must be very proud of your daughter.
You are proud of all my children. My son, Lou. My other daughter, Carrie. Is her name Carrie?
Pleasure to meet you. I'm Nick Arnstein. I'm a friend of Miss Price's.
Oh. Would you perhaps like to join us in a little poker game? Just a friendly little 3-cent limit.
A 3, did you say?
Hi, Mrs. Meeker.
Pleasure.
Your deal. Oh!
Here I'm worried about bringing him home.
You never worried about bringing me home.
Well, he's not from the neighborhood.
Neither am I.
Well, I guess a gentleman fits in anyway.
Fanny!
Oh, that Mr. Arnstein. The way he looks at home, huh? Got a feeling this is his first poker game.
A gentleman fits in anywhere.
So does a sponge. Stranger ought to act a little strange.
You think he's good looking?
Gorgeous. Oh, if you fall for that type of thing. I did. Reminds me of Fanny's papa. My ex, also gorgeous, and wherever he is, you should only stay there.
You don't find him a little slick?
Eddie, there are men who should be pursued, and there are men who should be avoided. Guess which ones usually get the girl?
Well, that's 57 cents for you and 39 cents for you and worth every penny.
A fine bunch of crooks I introduced you to.
Oh, we're just more in practice, is all. Oh, sit, children, sit. Fanny, I'm so happy for your success. Only one thing could make me happier. To dance at your wedding. Should I wait to kill her now? Now!
No, I love Mrs. Straycoach. Besides, if you knew how hard I had to work to win 57 cents, I had to cheat. I've been waiting all night to be alone with you.
Congratulations, Fanny! I was busy with the baby before!
Thank you, Mrs. Nadler!
Alone with you and a block full of your intimates.
Around here, you're never alone. Funny. I've imagined you practically every place in the world. London, Paris, Henry Street. Never.
Imagine.
Maybe it was the ruffled shirt. You're like a character in a book. And I haven't read so many books, so. So, it's your turn. Say something.
Would you say you're a woman of wide experience?
About what?
Men.
Men. Thousands. On the other side of the footlights. I'm too busy for that nonsense. How about you? Hundreds of girls, right?
Not merely dozens. Nothing serious, I like feeling free.
You can get lonesome being that free.
Get lonesome being that busy.
Who would think to look at us that we got the same problem? We travel single alone.
Children. Fanny, you're a wonderful girl, and I wish I could get to know you better.
Give me 6 good reasons why not.
Just one. I have to catch a train early in the morning to Kentucky.
What's in Kentucky?
After an interesting little farm, I breed racehorses.
Why? They can't do it themselves? Hey! Are you packed? What are you sitting here for? It's practically morning.
Had you not been such a success tonight, I would have asked you to come with me. It's a shame.
Oh, I don't know. But with opening night and a decent proposal. It was indecent, wasn't it?
Come with me.
Oh, thank God. I can tell Mrs. Strakosh things are looking up.
May I call you when I get back?
Sure. You want to borrow a nickel for the phone? Advances?
It does seem possible.
Before or after dinner?
You look beautiful.
You don't gotta make that leading lady dialogue with me. I'm a comic.
On stage.
That's where I live. On stage.
Now then, you're missing a lot.
Can't have it all.
Of course you can, as long as you insist on it.
Hey, somebody laid a blue marble egg on the table.
It's one of my favorite things. I picked it up in Europe ages ago. I thought you might like it.
A blue marble egg? White roses? You went to a lot of trouble for someone you weren't sure would show up.
I hoped you would. Just as much as I hope you like dry sherry.
I wouldn't know dry from wet.
Are you gonna be all right?
Please, I was raised in a saloon, remember?
What are you so angry about?
Who's angry? I'm sorry if I'm disappointing you, but what did you expect? You think just because we happen to be in the same city, you'd ask me out to dinner and I'd fall in love with you? Well, you may have been my first ruffled shirt, but I have met plenty of your kind since. You're not slumming here.
I never was, and you know it.
Don't holler at me!
Not hollering, you are.
That's different, I'm a natural hollerer. I'm not that kid from Kimi's anymore. I used to impress very easy. I'm a little older now.
Funny. You seem a lot younger. About 8, I'd say. A bad-tempered 8-year-old who hasn't had a supper.
Well then, get me my supper.
You know, when I passed by the theater today and saw you were here, I lit up like a Christmas tree.
Oh, because of great, big, wonderful me?
Now, don't make fun of yourself, Fanny, not dumb. And yes, it was because of great, big, wonderful you.
So, how come I haven't heard from you? You missed my last 2 opening nights.
I didn't miss a one.
You didn't come backstage?
Because you scared me to death.
Maybe we should order dinner.
Are you sure you want to stay?
Well, I'm here. I might as well eat.
Very sensible. I think we're ready now, Bob. Caviar to begin with, Mr. Arnstein. Pate Strasburg, I think. And a filet de boeuf sauce for the legs. Pomme de terre souffle, stemmed strawberries, and very light Bordeaux with the filet.
Salt to Emmy, you're 1905.
Perfect!
Thank you, Mr. Arnstein.
All right.
I would have ordered roast beef and potatoes.
I did.
I can't tell when you're ordering roast beef. How will I know when you're making advances?
Oh, you'll know. You are turned by a man. You are smaller, so I can be taller than. You are softer to the touch. It's a feeling something to be desired. Doesn't take more explanation than this. You are woman, I am man. Let's kiss.
Isn't this the height of nonchalance? Furnishing a bed in restaurants. Well, a bit of dinner never hurt. But guess who? Two good girls do just what mama says when mama's not around. It's a feeling, baby, what a feeling.
A bit of pate.
I drink it all day. Should I do the things to tell me to? It is pickle. What would Sadie do? In my soul, I feel an inner
Let's.
Yours, Mr. Bryce?
See, even he thinks it's a good idea.
Maybe I do want to marry you, but not when I'm broke.
Marry me for my money. I swear I won't be insulted.
That's exactly what people think.
Yes.
I do. Now, Fanny, I do want to marry you, right? Just not like this. It's going to be my way, but not at all.
Yes, Mr. Ronstein. What did you say, Mr. Ronstein? But you did say you're going to marry me.
Yes.
Last call. Train to New York, leaving on track 12.
And you said you love me.
Yes. I'll call.
And write.
Bye, Fanny.
Vera. Oh, look at that face. You might be the first person in history sorry to leave Cleveland. You ever do that? You ever turn your back and let what you want walk away?
More times than I can remember.
I can't do that.
Listen, kid, if you're gonna die every time you say goodbye to a man.
Where's Emma? Emma!
Yes, Fanny?
Get my luggage off that train. I'm not going to Chicago.
What?
And book me on the next train to New York.
Just where do you think you're going?
To Monte Carlo. With Nick Arnstein.
He asked you alone?
No, but he'll be glad when he sees me, I hope.
So you're just gonna throw yourself at him?
I love the guy, and I wanna be with him.
And you think he loves you?
Is that so impossible? Get her back to track 16!
Miss Price! Have you forgotten you're on tour with this show?
You'll be fine. You've got five other top names to fill in.
You'll be completely selfish and ungrateful and unprofessional.
Give it up, Flo, before your ulcer starts flaring up.
That's funny coming from you. You gave me this ulcer.
Listen, Flo, I love you. I love the theater. I love the audience, but I can't take them home with me. I want a life, too.
Fanny, if you do this, I'm through with you. And I mean it!
Fanny, you're making a fool of yourself.
This is right for me.
But is it right for Nick?
I'll make it right for him.
No! Fanny, take my advice and don't. Don't tell me not to live, just sit and play. Life's kidding.
Thank you.
can't believe you're in Monte Carlo!
I know you told me to wait until you had a fortune in each hand, but you've got horses and car gigs and oil wells. Sooner or later, one of those is gonna hit, so I don't see why I gotta wait. I wanna be a Sadie now.
A what?
A Sadie. Mrs. Straykosh's daughter, Sadie. She's a married lady.
Is there no escaping Henry Street?
It's a package deal, so what do you say?
You need an answer this moment?
You got something else to do?
Frankly, darling, I can barely think, let alone talk. I've been at the card table since lunch. Can we talk about this after I've had a little bit of sleep?
Yeah, sure, of course.
Thank you, Sadie. That's very thoughtful.
Did you just call me Sadie?
Oh, did I not tell you? What a great night I had at the tables!
How that man
eight, nine, ten, pay up, ladies.
Calm yourself. Lending a few hands of pitcher patient don't make you Nick Arnstein.
Aren't we moody?
Who's moody?
Well, you haven't smiled all afternoon.
What? Maybe I have things on my mind.
Such as?
Such as why are you always the last one to ante up?
Tell me about Fanny.
She couldn't be better. Thank you. They start rehearsal on the new show next week.
And guess who Ziegfeld's new head choreographer?
Congratulations, Daddy!
Thank you. Thank you.
But with the new baby, I thought she'd take a year off.
And why should she take a year off?
Their baby's such a short time. Blink and they're grown.
Oh, ain't it the truth? I remember when my Sadie was
and
little.
Who asked you?
Besides, Fanny's got plenty of help at home. Why shouldn't she go back to work?
She has to?
No, she doesn't have to. Maybe she's bored sitting around the house all day staring at a sleeping baby.
I'm just saying, I'd like to have an event with that son-in-law of yours lost in his California oil wells. But Fanny and Nick are okay, yes?
And we play cards.
I just thought that...
You thought less, concentrated more, you might win a hand now.
So, how about that Fanny opening her third Follies, biggest one yet?
In my dreams,
you I could have never dreamt.
I have to pinch myself to believe it. Little Fanny Price, a real legit star.
And why not? She wasn't exactly born into a family of no talents. I cut a pretty decent rug in my day.
And she always had me to show her the ropes, but do I ever get a bow?
Well, at least she got you a good job. What am I but a guilty babysitter?
My work is done. My work is done.
Her work is done. She doesn't need us. She'll have cake. We'll have crumbs. Be careful of the stage door. Here she comes. Here she comes. Hello, Fanny. Hello.
Hello, Fanny. It's me, Mama. What do you mean, Mama who?
From afar.
I lost a daughter, but I gained a star. Someone want to get that? Mrs. Carlson? Mama?
Stop hollering. Mrs. Carlson's with little Francis. I just gave her a bath.
Mrs. Carlson?
Ha, ha, ha. Fanny, you'll do me a favor next mansion your husband buys, you should have a few less wings. Maybe an escalator.
There's a driver at the door. Someone call for a taxi?
That would be for me. Can you ask him to wait, please?
Going to the city?
Just a train to Philadelphia. I got a tip from a friend who said that there was a group of investors passing through on their way to Philly. So, you know, I'm desperate to nab investors for my photo project.
But today's my first day of rehearsal. You promised. What am I supposed to do?
24 hours there and back, you won't even know I'm gone. Rosie, you'll hold down the fort for me, won't you?
Sure thing. What?
Nick, I don't think you should go.
And I don't want to go, darling. Business is business.
Nick, I mean it. I am starting the new show today, leaving little Francis for the first time. I am nervous enough as it is. You can't do this to me.
You have Mrs. Carlson, Emma, and your mother.
Absolutely.
See, not a worry in the world.
You promised. This is not what we talked about. You said if I went back to work, you would be here.
24 hours. No more.
You're right. Go. I'm being ridiculous. You go ahead. I'll stay home. Maybe I decided to go back to work too soon. I'll call Flo and tell him I just can't.
Fanny, can I get you help with something in the kitchen?
Stay out of this.
It's all right. It's all right, Rose. If that's what Fanny wants, I'll tell the cab to go.
Thank you. What? I gotta get to the theater.
Luxurious casino in the world.
Has he got it upstairs in the head, my fella?
He better have it downstairs in the pocketbook.
I actually stopped by hoping to run into you, Flo.
Me?
That was a once-in-a-lifetime deal I put together.
Sounds expensive.
Well, my biggest problem is trying to keep the wrong money out. I want to control this, Flo. Everything on me up and up. That's why I'm making this offer to just a few of my closest friends like you.
I'm flattered, Nick, but I do all of my gambling on the stage.
Well, there's no gambling here, Flo. Have a look. If there ever was a sure thing.
Maybe another time.
Offers like this don't go into your lap every day. Not like this.
Sorry, Nick.
Hey, Flo! You don't want me, want to leave the papers with you and you can look them over on your own, huh?
Could you two tycoons discuss this some other time on account of I need a word with the father of my child?
Of course, dear.
Eddie. Nicky, what are you doing here?
I need money, Fanny. They're pouring the foundations for the casino as we speak. I need investors and I need them now. And if I can't go out and tap my normal money people...
Oh, who needs money people when you got me?
You.
What's wrong with me? What am I, a kept woman? Listen, mister, it's all money. If we got a real marriage, then what's mine is yours. So do we or don't we got a real marriage?
Of course.
So we got a deal.
Fanny, it's $68,000 cash.
You know a good divorce lawyer? I'm in. Okay. You said, 68,000.
Yes.
Okay. Partner.
please, Fanny, don't hold so tight. Give me some air and some light. Somehow I'm lost, really lost. Somewhere the wires got crossed. You've gotta just set us straight. Hold, Nikki! Run, Nikki! Wait. All right. You're a partner. Hey, Mr. Arnstein, here's your name. It's a temperamental arrangement. When you're down, there's no way to go but up. I find that lady luck changes affection. Fortune's a fickle dame.
Full of surprises. I'm not proud of nothing, but things okay with you too?
Of
Couldn't be better. He had a great trip checking out the casino in Miami. Came back on top of the world.
You didn't have to write another check?
Stop. You don't like him. You never have.
It's your opening night, and where's he?
He'll be here.
As long as you're making the big bucks, he will.
You and I have been together a long time, so I'm gonna let that one slip.
I didn't mean it. I have this bad habit of worrying about you.
Break it.
All I'm saying is you work so hard for everything
you have. The hard work is all I ever got back. I used to wonder, when does the fun begin? When do the clowns come on?
But then the fabulous, magical Nick Arnstein showed up and the party began.
I got a dress. Where the hell is Emma? Nick?
Just stopping by to say how wonderful it is to have you back with us.
Thanks, Flo.
Yeah, break a leg, dear.
Flo, you didn't happen to see Nick out front, did you?
Sorry, dear, but I'll keep an eye out for him.
Thanks. No luck. I covered every racetrack, police station.
Did you try the hospitals?
Don't be so dramatic.
People get hit by cars all day long, don't they? I mean, he could be laying out there in the street somewhere, Emma.
Fanny, you're getting yourself all worked up over nothing.
I'll call the hospitals, but you gotta get on stage.
Come on, time for the clowns.
Thank you.
You were wonderful. Oh, wonderful. Fanny, you're making yourself sick for nothing. Something came up, that's all. Something came up, kept him late. But believe me, he'll be back.
Like my father? Because you're an expert on marriage, right?
Rose. Fanny.
Now, I'll be going.
Please stay, Rose.
There are places a mother doesn't belong. In the middle of marriage is one. Important thing is you're all right. Talk, children. Don't howl. Talk.
First time of a fight, you're playing to an empty house. So, you want to tell me why you ruined my opening night?
I'm sure your audience didn't suffer because of me.
Damn right they didn't. But how do you think I felt? Out there trying to be funny while I'm worried if you're laying dead in some gutter and you don't even care enough to let me know you're okay!
I don't care!
Not enough to be here!
What the hell with you and your opening night? I lost everything today! Everything that I've been working for! God said, you know what, Nick? My friend, things are going too good for you. We can't have that. So he hit a big wind and he blew it all to hell!
What are you talking about?
A hurricane! A hurricane! It hit Florida and it wiped me right off the map. Gone, all of it, the casino, my money, your money, it's all gone.
Nicky, when I hollered at you, I
didn't want to tell you before the show, but I needed a couple of drinks, a little time to think.
What's to think? Even the great Nick Arnstein can't control the weather.
I'm not listening. We're wiped out. We're broke.
So we're broke. We got our health and little Francis and each other. And I know you didn't lose your ruffled shirt because I got that hit so good Sherlock Holmes couldn't find it. You're Nick Arnstein. 2 weeks, you'll be back on top.
And if I'm not, what are you going to do? Write another check?
Why not? What's mine is yours. Hell, without you, I'd still be singing the drunks back at Keeney's.
Don't patronize me.
All right. But first you're going to have to tell me what that means. Nick, don't turn away from me. Let me help you. You do so much for me. What do I ever get to do for you?
Stronger for my
Salesman?
With a real life of talent. Did you know he was the first to discover me at a burlesque house?
And darling, the best part is Mr. Rinaldi is offering me a full partnership without a penny of my investment.
As I said, I've got the money. What I need from you is that air of distinction that you'd bring to the enterprise.
That's a pricey air.
That's the offer.
Well, that's very generous. Too generous. Fanny, how much money did you put into this agency?
20 grand.
Well, it's a deal after the 68 grand I lost last year. Thank you, Mr. Rinaldi. I'm sorry that your time has been wasted.
Well, you can't blame a girl for trying. Nick, I'm so sorry.
Fanny, you promised. You promised, and then you did it again.
I know. I only thought with the right...
Fanny! I am not a child. You can't pay the babysitter to keep me amused.
I was only trying to help.
No one asked for your help. I got along just fine without you, and I can get along again. Just leave it alone, Fanny, huh? I'm begging you. Leave it alone.
I'm sorry, but the car is here. We've got that photo shoot for Life magazine before the radio show.
Go on, you'll be late.
So I'll be late.
You can't be late. How could the world get on without Fanny Price making me the fun? It's all right. It's all right, huh? Go on.
Funny, baby, you're sure funny. If you're one thing, honey, you're a
funny. Beepman 4119. Tom Lefty. Hello, Lefty. Nick Garnstein. Yeah, good, good. Listen, are you still peddling that fancy bond deal? Because I'm in a listening mood these days. Risky. That doesn't bother me as long as it's profitable. I'm gonna need $68,000 in advance. Well, let me put it to you this way. If you got the 68 grand, then risk or no risk, you got me. Yeah. All right, I'll be there. Well, he it ain't so funny.
It'll be news every time I visit him in prison.
He should have thought of that before he did this to you.
Eddie, you have no idea what Nick did for me. Go away, please.
Brushed and good as new. You've been sitting here
her all this time? Just doing the math. Come up with the right answer. Is there a right answer? Will you see Mr. Ziegfeld? He's outside. Come on in, Flo.
This is it?
The night Nick Arnstein gets sprung from the clink, this is it.
You haven't been up to see him?
At first I went, but he didn't really want me there.
Have you spoken to him?
Not yet.
John, just call 5 minutes to places.
I'll set your props.
I'd better let you dress.
One thing, Flo. I want to do this his way from now on. You understand? Whatever he says goes. And if that means giving up the theater and staying home, I hope you'll be a sport about it.
Well, why don't we worry about that when it happens? Have a great show.
You know that however I act, whatever I say, it's because to me you are special. I thought at that first day at Keeney's, man, was I right. Look at you. You're Fanny Bryce.
I couldn't have done it without you.
I wouldn't go that far.
Eddie, you know how much I love you. Would you just shut up and take the compliment?
Be happy, my friend. Be happy.
Straight here. I didn't stop by to see the baby. But she's not so much of a baby anymore, is she?
Waiting to see her. She's getting to be this young lady, and oh, she's gorgeous just like you. Who says I'm not lucky? I feel like a kid on a blind date. You as scared as me.
Fanny, I've had 3 years to think.
Nick, before you go on, I've had the same 3 years to go over and over what happened, and I know how much of it was my fault, how many stupid, fakakta things I did, but I can change. I know I can. I promise you.
I'm sorry, darling. People don't really change. Haven't we knocked each other around enough? Why don't we just cut it off before one of us can't get back up again?
Wow. I mean, wow, am I glad you stopped me? You should have heard the rest of that speech. I've been rehearsing it for weeks.
Fanny.
Nick, I swear, I was just telling you what I thought you wanted to hear, but really, I feel exactly the way you do.
You mean that?
Of course I do. Boy, am I glad we don't have to get all tragic about this. If we both feel the same way, then ending it is a good thing, wouldn't you say? A lot of it was awfully good, you gotta admit. You did a lot for me, Nick. That's what I'm gonna remember.
What did I do for you, darling, huh? What did I give you that you couldn't have gotten on your own?
My daughter. And only you would have given me a blue mauve leg. You made me feel almost... sort of... beautiful.
You are. I've actually had to fight my way through the crowds of people that are here to see you. You don't want to keep them waiting. Bye, Finn.
Thank you.
hear that. Funny. Yeah, the guy said, honey, you're a funny girl. That's me. I just keep up in stitches. Doubled in half. And though I may be all wrong for the guy, I'm good for a laugh.
Thank you.